So I'm with the one only John David Jackson, trainer extraordinaire, former world champion with Clarissa Shields, training Clarissa Shields right now. Let us know about your thoughts with this upcoming fight and what kind of fighter you got in your stable.
Well, the fight should be a good fight because you have two females. Let me take that back. You have two fighters that are coming to fight. So that's going to make for an exciting fight right there. If her opponent is ready for some, and she's going to take the punishment that Clarissa's going to dish out, it should be one hell of a fight. Clarissa's a great student. She listens and she learns fast. And she's willing to accept whatever I try to show her to make her become a better fighter. So this should be a really good, interesting fight for the boxing fans.
What do you see, or what do you bring to the table when she came to you? What did you see? Was there anything that you thought you like? Okay, I can make adjustments here and have her make adjustments there.
Yeah, first thing I'd say is her amateur coach did a great job. People don't realize he did a great job teaching her the fundamentals of boxing. My job was not to make her become a better professional and make that transition from amateur, great amateur fighter, to great professional fighter. And, when you have a student that's willing to listen and learn to everything you're trying to show her or show that person, it makes for a great team. Chris, she's a fast learner, and the beauty of Chris is she likes to fight. She fights more than most men want to fight, man. So that makes it more of a joy to train and teach her how to become a better professional. Once she just slows her punches down and doesn't look for the knockout right away and just starts breaking them down real slow, man, she's the best female fighter on the planet today. But she wants to be the best female fighter of all time. And that's a great goal that she's working towards.
With Hammer out, we can still expect that fight to take place when she comes back, correct?
We hope so. We don't know where Hammer's at right now. Does she fight? Does she not want to fight? She does modeling, so boxing may not be a bad thing. If she can make money at modeling, hey, I'd rather do that than get beat up fighting someone. So, we have to put her to the side right now and get other fights for Clarissa because, this is her career. And the career, her window of opportunity is only going to be for so long. So if Hammer wants to play games and not fight, then we move on. If she wants to come on back and get in the mix, she's more than welcome.
She's so good, so she... I'm going to say it like this.
She's so good. She's so good.
who can she, once she wins, or when she wins, who is she to fight? Like, who's left?
Well, there are a couple females on the scene. They may be overseas. They may be under the radar. But there are females that she can fight. She has a great management team with Mark Tappet, and a great, our promoter, Demetrius Stevens leading. So, and they're working with Eddie Hearns now. So the sky's the limit for her. And it's a beautiful marriage that she has with these three gentlemen. And she can go as far as she wants to go. And there's a lot of female fighters out there that a lot, unfortunately for me, female fighters, they don't make the money that the male fighters make. So with her coming along and some of the other female fighters that are out there making a name for themselves, it might enhance their purses. And that, if you want to see somebody fight, offer them some money. Most boxers fight for $2 and a biscuit. So you give them some real money, they'll fight. And that's the beauty of fighting Clarissa. The money's out there for you to fight. And so as long as the money's out there, she'll have a good opponent in front of her.
Last but not least, what can we expect on fight night November 17th in Kansas? I got to say in Kansas.
Well, boxing's everywhere. Between the two of them, you should expect one great fight. The whole card should be a real good card. I'm training Louis Addius, and he's fighting Gabe.
You work with him also?
Yeah, so that, the whole card that evening.
A lot of heat right there, too, right there, man.
Oh, yeah, that might be the fight of the night if they both come in and do their thing. It should be a great card. There's a lot of great fights, and people should tune in and DAZN to see the fights that they're showing because the fans deserve these kind of fights, and DAZN is definitely showing them, so be a part of it.
Thank you for your time. Oh, one more question. I know you're not training Sergey anymore. I just got to ask, what are your thoughts on his return match with Eldia Alvarez?
Alvarez is champ now, and he maybe before he defeated Sergey, maybe he believed it, but maybe not quite all the way. But now he's taking Sergey's best shots, and he came back and won the fight. Now he knows he can beat Sergey. Listen, the blueprint's out there. If you can withstand the shots that Sergey hits you with and go to his body the whole time, it breaks Sergey down. And now, before Sergey lost a war, mentally, he was unstoppable. But after the second war fight, mentally, he was destroyed. Now, this kid really kind of buried him. Now Sergey said, can he come back mentally and be that killer he once was? Because the cover's been taken off of him. You know, that plate of armor is no longer there. Now people know you're more than vulnerable and you're capable of being stopped. You're not that killer that you once were. Can you come back and prove to the world that you're a good fighter? Or was it all just a hype job for you? Because he was a bully to a degree. Now you got to prove that you know, you're the underdog now. Can you beat this kid? Or has the wool been pulled from over the cover from over you? Because now he has to come back and prove that, you know, he wants it. The man made some money and he's kind of got soft. You know, that was our problem. He didn't want to train any longer. I got to train positively. So it's up to him what he's going to do. You know, he's a great guy with him now. Buddy McGregor's a great guy, great trainer. But is he willing to listen? See, that marriage might be good for the first month, but once Sir get back in his own head, he always said American trainers can't teach anything.
Yeah.
So guess what? You went got another black American trainer. So was he going? How long that going to last for? If Alvarez does what he's supposed to do, he wins the rematch.
Let me ask you this before you go. If Sergey loses, do you think it's time for him to say, hey, I'm good, I'm not, it's enough's enough?
Beat up a few more times, you know. keep fighting, get it beat up a few more times, you know. You know, you deserve that. So, you know, but I don't care what he does. But if he loses, he's done anyway. Nobody wants to see him anymore.
Put the head to bed. Was it Andre Ward that really did it to him, like to say, you know, this is the reason why we're getting the Sergey we're getting now? Or is this just who Sergey is?
It's a bit of both. You hit around here on both. Andre exposed him for being a bully. That, you know, he was a front runner. Once Sergey's best chance to win it was the first fight. Because, you know, Andre had problems. And just like, you know, his knees and stuff like that. You know, he had not fought consecutively for a long time. That was Sergey's best chance. He didn't listen. So when I thought he won the fight, he didn't listen. It was a draw. I mean they give the war, but I thought Sergey won the fight. But then, after that, you can't listen. Ward, he's smart. Second time around, he's going to make, he going to correct all his mistakes and realize the thing that you did to him. He showed that. And then Sergey got drunk in front of Ward and Virgil Hunter after a press conference. Now, how stupid is that? Is that my fault?
No.
And, you know, so he proved what he was all about. So and Andre is a smart guy. Virgil is a very intelligent guy. They found ways to break him down and go. And the one thing I knew, if they went to the body, he was done. That's why I said in this fight here, and Sergey's 100% dedicated, and this cat's going to the body and protecting, breaking him down, it's over. It's over.
Thanks,
my pleasure.
Good luck with
Thank you, bro. I appreciate it. Anytime. Thank you very much.
All right.